Game design. Perfect.
Awesome.
This is the best.
That is really
this
top
is
of the line
incarnate
animation right there.
Okay, anyway.
I'm surprised you didn't start in the water.
Yeah, I know. I'm Octo.
And this is Looney.
And that's an unprofessional opener. Brought to you by Tangential Gaming. Come on, switch. Okay, so I'm playing now. You can tell because it's the fun sections of the game.
And he actually knows where he's going.
It's the sections where I don't have to fight 30 dudes at the same time. I swear I'm not doing that on purpose. Or am I? No, I'm not.
Look at that bush. It looks so
I know,
real.
Right? Oh, man. Yay. Who puts the door mechanism and the trap mechanism on the same thing? Like, who does that?
Ubisoft.
Apparently. Ubisoft Montreal. Hurry up. Hurry up. Hurry up. Hurry up. Hurry up. Thank you. Oh, spikes! Okay. I really hope the door has not closed. Or gotten beyond the point of...
Oh, you're good, you're good, you're good, you're good. Booyah!
Is that you? This part. I don't like this part either. This is more fighting, so I obviously didn't do it on purpose. Hello. I don't know what you are. We talked about that, right? Like, that guy's outfit.
Yeah.
He's in straps and he has a chain. I don't know what he's used for.
He's like those guys from Zelda, the mummies.
Yeah. Do you know what they're called?
I'm trying to remember the actual correct name.
Are you talking the mummies or the zombies? Like the mummies without the wraps on them. Because they're two different things.
I'm talking about with the wraps on them.
Okay,
you know,
those are Gibdos.
Okay.
Well, at least they are in the original episode, though. I don't know if they are at the time. I can't remember right now. But the guys in... is it Castletown? Is that what it's called in Ocarina of Time? When you're in the castle? Like you're...
Yep.
Yeah, right before you get to the Temple of Time? Yeah, those are called Redux.
Oh, okay.
I wanted to stab the chick on the ground, but okay. This is what I was talking about. Whoa! If you push X on the wall and then attack, so you don't like jump over them like that.
Okay.
Off the wall, he just does like a straight at them and it just takes them out every time. Except these dudes. These dudes block, I think.
Gotcha.
But they're red, so you can run over them. Yeah, they block it. You can run over them. These block everything because they're super fun fighting against.
Nice
shot.
Yeah.
Sweet camera angle.
Yeah. We see that again?
There.
That's good directing right there.
Why am I looking at the feet? Come on! I'm not into feet. I'm into killing things with swords. No, hit him, hit him, hit him!
Wow, the response of this game is tremendous.
It's great, it's fantastic, there's nothing wrong with it, I swear.
Alright. You can really see how they've polished it up since
yeah.
then, like...
So, yeah, people who played the Forgotten Sands be like, this is not as good as the old games. And then I'm like, really? When was the last time you played the old games?
Yeah.
Like, they're still good.
Yeah.
But, like...
People are remembering,
so
it's the memory, right?
Yeah.
It's the experience.
It's the nostalgia glasses.
Yeah. But whatever your experience was at that point is what you remember.
Yeah.
It's like you challenge me to play GoldenEye again, and it's, yeah, the frame rate is really ridiculously low.
Yeah. It's like one explosion happens, and it drops down to, like, 3 frames a second.
Yeah. But you know what? I still remember it as being really fun, and that's what that's what I'm going to remember.
That was the camera angle it came back on. It's great. It's fantastic. All right. I'm not going to look into this, because I don't care about it. This is the secret path.
The super secret path.
Super secret path. Only cool guys take this path.
Stay there! I'll come to you! Can you hear me?
Okay, where is Farrah? Come on.
I'm in here!
Come on. I know where it is. Come on, let me walk. Oh, camera.
I actually really, really love the two most modern Prince of Persia games.
This is the one titled Prince of Persia, and then
Forgotten Sands.
Forgotten Sands, yeah, it's really good.
Those two are really, really fun.
People hated on the Forgotten Sands. Forgotten Sands, when you can freeze the water.
Oh, that's so awesome.
That is seriously controlling the coolest platforming.
Controlling the elements while at the same time running across. Like, imagine this game, only you've got to control the elements as well. Yeah. It's awesome.
It's so good. It's so good.
It is.
Like, I mean, I guess I could understand where people would feel a little ripped off because it was $60 and the game was relatively short once you knew what you were doing. But, like, that's their problem, right? Like, people always feel robbed unless you're coming. And a game doesn't necessarily need multiplayer.
Yeah, it's true.
So stupid. Like, not everything has to have multiplayer components. A lot of times that breaks games.
Yeah, it's true.
That are single player only, and they're like, oh, well, we have to make stuff for multiplayer, so...
How do you feel about Assassin's Creed multiplayer?
I feel like it's not necessary, but it's a fun distraction.
It is.
It's okay, let me rephrase. It's super fun when you're playing with your friends and you know you're playing like you're supposed to be playing, not running in their rooms the entire time.
That was I only did that to you one time.
It's the most annoying thing. It's like, hey, let's be stealthy. What? Just running along the roofs and I can't catch you, so I can't get any points.
Do you remember the first round we actually played? Do you remember I was pretending that I had no idea what I was doing?
Yeah. Well, yeah, the entire time you're like, what do I do? Where do I... am I attacking you? And I'm like, no, you're trying to hide from me. Meanwhile, you know exactly what you're doing. And I'm like, Looney, you have to hide, you know, with people that look like you. And then I killed someone that looked exactly like you, and it was a civilian. And you were like, I am. And then you just, like, pulled me into the haystack.
The haystack, yeah.
Beat the crap out of me and left me knocked out. And I was like, all right, I see how it is. All right.
Yeah. Mind games.
It is fun when you have a giant group of people. But I don't have a lot of friends that are super into Assassin's Creed multiplayer. Unfortunately, like, it is super fun when you play it how it's meant to be played.
Yeah. It was funny. My wife and I were playing Monopoly the other night together.
Yeah.
And it was the first time we ever played together. And I like to use mind games. Mm-hmm. And she got frustrated at the end of the game with me because she's like, some things you say are true, and other things you say are totally bogus. I'm like, yeah, I know.
That's the point.
That's what I'm trying to do.
It's really so unsportsmanlike. I'm like, you mean smart?
Yeah.
You're right.
So now, you know, she just... I think takes everything I say with a grain of salt.
Yeah. Well, that's like everyone. Okay, so we have family nights because we have a sister, right? So it's like mom, dad, you, me, and our sister.
Yeah.
And, and your wife and then my sister's husband. And they come over and we play Clue. DVD Clue. So it's like there's animations and stuff going on screen and stuff like that. And it's super fun, super cool. And every time everyone like is like, you're cheating. I'm like, I'm not cheating because I'm technically not cheating because there's no rule against watching someone else write something down as long as I'm not seeing what they are writing. So it's not my fault if I can see the way their pencil is like writing something, or it's also not cheating to look at the screen when they're trying to pick their answers. It's not my fault if you don't enforce that house rule. I'm just saying.
I think our sister has a different opinion on that.
I'm not cheating. There's no rule against it.
Yeah.
Hall of Learning, that's what's coming up. So we're going to extend this episode into it.
Sounds good.
Yes, I'm going to continue without saving. Look, Farrah has a crush on you. With her sweet pixelated face.
Yeah, I was going to say her square nose.
What did you call me?
It doesn't matter. The important thing is, I know how we can reach the top.
So romantic.
I know, right?
Of course. The hourglass.
Don't you like how I killed your father and all your soldiers and took you as a slave? I am a romantic. All to go on a date with you.
Their clothes look a little stiff.
Yeah, I know, right? Actually, the prince's pants are kind of wavy.
Yeah.
I'm afraid. What if I get into...
Oh my gosh, Farrah, stop being sassy.
Please.
She can't help it.
In every game she's in, she's sassy.
How many games is she in?
Well, she's in this game and the two throws.
Okay. Then they dumped her.
Well, in the second game, it makes sense that she's not there. And
I'm afraid.
In the Forgotten Sands also
trouble?
Makes sense because you, the prince, are off somewhere completely different. You're going to see your brother Malik.
That is true.
That was a sweet game. Super good. Remember the ending, the end boss battle, how you got to
over
him?
Here!
Where you're jumping through the sand tornado?
I don't know if I remember that.
Oh, it's so cool. So cool.
Alright,
okay,
all right.
Here's all the learning.
I love this.
Of course, there's a fight to start it, but...
Of course there is.
Okay, I don't need the cutscene. I don't need the cutscene. I know what I'm doing.
Mashing buttons isn't gonna help this.
It makes you feel better though, right?
Yeah, it does.
All right,
feel way better.
Let's find the way out.
All right. You want to start with hitting this wall right away before you fight anyone. I'm just gonna do that. That's all I'm gonna do. Boop. Ugh. Camera. Dude. Seriously? We're not just complaining for the sake of complaining. You would have to play it.
Yeah.
It. Maybe it's just the port, but I doubt it.
No, I think it's probably the game.
Like, if we do Warrior Within and the Two Thrones, it's not going to be on the HD release because the ports are very bad for those two games. The audio will cut out.
And you said sometimes it freezes,
the
right?
The Two Thrones freezes very, very often. It's not my PS3. My PS3 is almost brand new. I got it last year. So, it's definitely not the PS3. 2 years ago. Yeah, so it's not the PS3. I kept it in really good condition. I didn't use it very often. So it's like, it's not dust. It's not anything like that. It's just the game freezes. I swear. It's because no other game does it on my PS3. Not The Last of Us, not any of the Metal Gear games, not Resistance, even though that game isn't very good. Black Flag.
The camera very much reminds me of the Assassin's Creed. Like I said, the Assassin's Creed 1 camera. But since then, they've really, really improved it.
Well, yeah, that's just like the the Forgotten Sands camera, at least how I remember it. I played that game probably 2 months ago. Was really good. Or probably more like 5 months ago.
Yeah.
It was really, really good. I also played it on New Game Plus, so I had all my powers. So I just destroyed everything for like the first 3 quarters of the game.
I know, speaking of kind of cameras and game engines and stuff, I know Halo Reach wasn't the most popular, but I really enjoyed the engine.
Yeah, people love Halo Reach. I'm the only one you'll ever talk to that doesn't.
Okay.
I don't like the multiplayer game, and everyone's like, why?
But I'm talking about the single player game engine.
Oh yeah, it's fantastic.
It's just very smooth,
yeah.
Very easy to play.
And even saying like it's a Halo I don't like is saying like it's, you know, my least favorite flavor of ice cream. It's still fantastic.
Right, yeah.
Or it's like my least favorite flavor of potato chip, you know what I mean? It's like, there's still potato chips, I still dig them.
What is your least favorite? Ketchup chips?
Ketchup, probably, which is ironic.
It is.
You love
yeah,
ketchup.
You are. You're ketchup
guy.
Ketchup all.
Yeah. But yeah, I didn't like Reach's multiplayer, and people would hate on me for it, because they're like, you're anti Halo, but I was super into Halo multiplayer for a while. I just don't like the DMR. I think it's overpowered. The DMR is a single shot rifle.
Oh.
It replaced the battle rifle, which was a three-burst rifle. And everyone loved it except me, because I was like, it's too easy to use.
Did you like the Perfect Dark port onto the 360?
Oh yeah, perfect.
I see what you did there.
Didn't even mean to.
Yeah.
No, but yeah, that is how to do a port. Because they didn't change anything. All they did, like they didn't add new guns or anything like that. All they did was make it look better and then update the controls. All you need to do.
I remember when that game came out, there was two things that really stood out to me that made it more advanced than the rest of the games at the time. That was, first of all, the blood on the wall.
Yep.
When you would shoot them. And the second thing was when you would shoot them up high, they would fall.
Yeah, and they'd actually fall.
They would actually fall, yeah.
They would just lie there.
Those two things were like, wow, you know?
Yeah.
Now it's nothing, but yeah, it's just standard.
Perfect Dark was super revolutionary at the time because it was also the only game at the time when it came out that needed the expansion pack.
Yeah.
To play the single player.
Yeah, that's right.
And then, which is weird to me, you think that the expansion pack would be needed for multiplayer, not single player. But that's just me. But then, do you know the other games that needed the expansion pack?
Donkey Kong was
Donkey Kong
one.
64.
That's
did,
it
did
off
Majora's
the
Mask need it? I actually don't remember.
I don't remember.
I think there was 4 or 5 games that required it.
I'll go.
Donkey Kong 64, Perfect Dark. I don't remember the other ones.
She said my love.
Yeah. I'd have to look online
yeah,
or something.
I didn't dream it.
I remember, though, the day that I got the expansion pack.
Yeah.
It's quite natural.
This is Blockbuster.
A kingdom's conquered. She has nothing,
yeah.
No one to protect
her. Yeah,
now
Blockbuster's no
she
more.
She needs
yeah.
me.
I miss Blockbuster.
I can see it in the way she looks at
yeah.
it.
Not for movies. I miss
all
their
I'd have
section.
To do is
yeah.
reach out.
I was going to say,
take
and
her
if you wanted to buy a movie there, it was always
mine.
Way more expensive.
Why am I talking
yeah,
to myself?
If you wanted to buy a game there, way cheaper.
Mm-hmm.
Way cheaper. And when you would trade games in
you
there,
did it.
Like, we have EB Games in town, but back when we had, like, 2 or 3 Blockbusters in town, no, there's only 2, I would go to EB Games and, like, we can give you, like, $5 for it. Go to Blockbuster and, like, yeah, we can give you 15 to 20. So I only sold games at Blockbuster. When I traded in my original Xbox in 2006... No, it was 2007. It was early 2007. Not early. It was in August. It was right before Halo 3 and Call of Duty 4 came out. Which, those are the things that made me antisocial because it was like that was my life for like 2 years were those 2 games.
Yeah.
I traded in my Xbox original and I had like 75 games for it. Or something crazy. I had
stay
more
there.
Than that. I had an
I'll
insane
come to
amount. Because I never sold stuff for the original Xbox. I just kept it all. I turned that the wrong way like an idiot.
It's
there
no
was an Xbox
here.
Original game.
There's no life.
That,
I can see that.
It was rare, but I didn't know it was rare, and apparently neither did they, because I bought it from that Blockbuster about 3 months earlier for $20, and it was a game called Winback, which it was Winback and then the subtitle, I don't remember the subtitle, but Winback was a game for the N64 that I really loved. It was actually one of the only games for the N64 that utilized the memory card, and that's why I would always keep our N64 on, because we didn't have a memory card. I traded that in, long story short. It was $20 to buy it from there 3 months earlier, traded in for $40.
Wow.
Because it was a rare game.
You doubled your profit.
I doubled it. And to be honest, if like I had the same mentality now, or if I had the mentality I have now, back then, I wouldn't have sold it. Because if it's a rare original Xbox
yeah,
game...
Yeah, it could be worth a lot of money.
Yeah. Maybe not a ton. Maybe like, you know, $60-$70. But still...
Well, I know there's a guy in town here who buys Xbox games still.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, the comic book shop.
Really?
Yep.
Should go there.
Yeah, remember when you went there for your...
The Smash Brothers Melee tournament. Yeah.
Yeah, the... Not the owner, but the other guy that was there.
Oh, right. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Yeah.
That guy's a cool guy.
Yeah, because he comes in there.
Yeah. I wanted to buy the remake of Resident Evil for the GameCube from him, but it was like $50.
Yeah.
So, yeah, it's a little steep. But yeah, I think I traded all my Xbox games and my original Xbox for like $700.
Wow.
So it was like, that's how I bought my first Xbox 360 in like 3 games and then pre-ordered Halo 3 like all in one swoop and paid it all off.
Wow.
I remember I came in with a garbage bag and that was, because that was how I was carrying all my stuff. And I went in there and I walked, like, to the... Like, I was walking around, because you had to walk around to get to the counter. And there was a dude there, and he saw me starting to walk towards him. And he went, I'm on break, and walked away, and someone else went.
From?
And I was like, I'm trading all these in. He's like, I know. it took us, like, an hour.
He didn't
want to
do it.
The other guy's like, I'm taking a break. And this, like, the other guy's like, I had to do it all. And he was like, he's like, did you steal any of these games? And I'm like, no. He's like, do you have ID? I'm like, no. He's like, do you have a parent with you? I'm like, no. He's like, we're like halfway through ringing them all up already, and he just forgot to ask at the beginning. He's like, do you promise you didn't steal any of these games? And I was like, yeah. And he's like, okay, I'm just gonna keep going. Because you're supposed to check your ID, right? So in case there's ever a game reported stolen or whatever, and it's sold to them, they know who did it.
That's so funny.
But he was just like, okay, whatever. It was great. It was fantastic.
What's that That's amazing. Supposed to mean?
One of my favorite, like, gaming stories.
You want to be useful?
I remember that now. That's funny.
Tell us how to get out of here.
This isn't that kind of game.
Game?
Oh, come on.
She thinks this is a game.
So if this was Farrah doing this, she would stop to look at herself in the mirror.
Yeah, probably. Is that hitting that?
Looks like it.
No, it's not, because it should be... There we go.
Stay there! I'll come to you!
Now that does something I don't remember. All the way down below.
They did a Mythbusters on this sort of thing. It doesn't work.
What, the reflecting light?
Yeah, because the sun... Well, actually, the sun doesn't move. The Earth is moving around the sun.
Oh, yeah, I didn't think
But the
that.
Sun is... It's going too fast. It loses the beam.
Yeah. Well, I mean, in this game, it's like a gem that's producing the light.
Mm.
I think, at least. Maybe not. Maybe I'm stupid. That's entirely
possible. If the light source is the sun, it wouldn't work.
Yeah. It makes sense.
It works for about 30 seconds.
Yeah, that's stuff you just wouldn't think about.
Yeah. Well, that's why I love Mythbusters.
Yeah.
Well, I love watching it, and sometimes I'm like, aww. Because you like... to believe certain things.
Yeah, it wrecks some stuff.
It does.
Now,
like, you told me one the other day. You can't shoot a padlock with a gun.
Yeah, it doesn't work. In this, it's like a super high caliber, but you'd be more likely to hit yourself with a ricochet.
Yeah. I mean, that's...
So it's just not worth it.
Yeah.
Well, now you know, if you're ever in a situation where you have to shoot a padlock, put someone else in front of you, and then shoot it a few times. There you go. Yeah, I think they tested that. I think they shot it once and then tried to pull it apart, and it just didn't hit the locking mechanism. Because the bullet is like, it's a curved surface, right?
Yeah.
So the bullet's just sliding and like hitting so many different things.
And then there's another thing that they disproved, and that's that you can't shoot a barrel of gas,
yeah.
Right? A barrel of gasoline.
Yeah.
It won't explode.
Yeah, which I think everyone knew in their minds already. They just wanted to, you know, believe it because James Bond did it.
Yeah. It does make a... Oh, nice shot.
Yep, nice shot of the nice pixelated slide.
Yeah. I'm
trying to remember exactly where to go. I know where to go, I just don't know how to get there. This is supposed to break. Yep. Wow, you're a jerk.
Convenient.
That, kids, is what we like to call padding. Padding the gameplay right now to make me run around so the game seems like it's longer. That's exactly what that is.
I don't think that's what
that is. What that is, man. How do I get over there? I'm trying to get over... Yep. There. Over here.
If you were Bruce Wayne, you could just call for your grapple extender thing.
Yeah. Like, I see how I'm supposed to get over there. Camera, wow, you are literally my favorite thing on the planet right now. You're great. You're fantastic. I love everything about you. Okay, I think I know what to do. I feel like an idiot.
You got a little sarcasm on your mouth there.
I don't know what you're talking about. I'm being completely and totally serious. And I'm an idiot because I jumped over here and I didn't need to. Long episodes, man. Making me go crazy. It's like 27 minutes.
28, actually.
Thanks. Makes me feel great about myself. Hall of Learning. Fun. It is actually fun. I like puzzles.
Yeah.
I'm a puzzle guy. Do you like puzzles?
I do like puzzles.
You fan of jigsaw puzzles?
Depends.
I remember back when we lived in one of our old houses, we had a huge jigsaw puzzle. At least, I was really young, so I remember it being massive. But it was like, it covered like half of the floor. At least that's how I remember it. And it was like a giant African landscape.
Really? I don't remember that.
Puzzle at all? No?
No.
Here we go. Right? This looks right.
It does look right.
This looks right. No. 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 I want...
Other
no.
way.
I want you to turn. There we go. One more. There we go. Yeah! Perfect!
Oh!
Let me guess, that middle part's gonna break? Yeah. Man, it's like you can tell. Here we go. Spin. There we go. Okay, so now I gotta break all these walls. Because I have to get the light to shine down.
How did you know that you could go through there?
I know, right? It's not like the walls even, like, relatively look different. Come on. Is this the last one? It is the last one. Okay. So what we want to do is grab this.
I remember this part.
Yeah. Grab this. Out this way. Like that. And I believe... camera. This will... Yes, do that. And then I have to switch the mirrors. And then this will unlock the door. I believe. I could be wrong. Just gotta bring this mirror over here. Moving things. Oh. There we go.
Awesome!
Yay! Now we're going to get the sword, this new sword, which is the second last sword in the game, if I remember correctly. The last sword in the game somehow defies the every law that this game has taught you, because you don't need to have the Dagger of Time to kill the sand creatures once you have the last sword. And that, as you can probably tell, is my favorite sword in the game. Because then I can just slash them like twice and they die. Here we go. There.
Awesome!
New sword! Pretty cool looking sword.
He should have cut himself. Ow!
Wonder how long it's going to take for him to take his shirt off. It's not very much longer.
Well, he's not Matthew McConaughey, so.
Well, I mean, he does take his shirt off. I think it's awesome that Matthew McConaughey won an Oscar.
Yeah.
For the best actor. That's sweet.
You know, he's in Angels in the Outfield.
Is he actually?
Yeah.
Sweet.
He plays one of the players.
That's awesome.
Yeah.
Here's the thing about Matthew McConaughey. I love his acting because half of his acting is bad. But the other half is really good. So it's like, you can't tell if he's a bad actor or he's acting bad on purpose.
I think that's what makes him...
Matthew McConaughey.
Matthew McConaughey, yeah.
It's exactly what makes him that. So I'm going to do this last fight here, and then we're going to do, like, the Pillar of Sand, and then we'll end it. At least I hope there's a Pillar of Sand here. If there's not, we're just going to end it after this battle. Okay, cutscene. I understand. I have to run through some things. I've been fighting these enemies the entire game. You don't need to show me a cutscene, like, telling me about it.
Can they actually fall off the edge?
No, they teleport back up. Well, they can, but they teleport. That's the thing with the other games, you can just throw them off the edge and they'll fight them. And you're good.
Yeah, that's always a good option.
Ouch.
What was that?
I have no idea. He was doing dance.
Little Jake.
Oh. I wanted to stab this guy, but that's cool.
Nice camera.
Man, let's make him fight a whole bunch of guys right in this little area. I'm just happy there's walls here, or else I'd probably be dead by now.
Probably. That's what I appreciated about Assassin's Creed I love the fights outside.
Yeah. And it only got better with the games going on.
Yeah, it did.
Like, in the first game, it was wait to counter them. In the second game, it was like, you can do the thing where you push attack right when you hit them, and he does, like, a special kill. And then in the third game, it was like, you can just change... Or, no, I think it was in Revelations when they first did that, or Brotherhood 1 and 2, where once you start one kill, you can just push attack towards another person.
Yeah.
And he just does it. You keep the chain going as long as you want.
Yeah, absolutely. The improvements from 1 to 2 was unbelievable.
Yeah.
Like,
2 is still my favorite of the series, but I haven't played 4 yet.
Yeah, I think 2 and 4 are probably going to be your favorites.
Yeah. I really hope 4 is good. 3 was disappointing because it was glitchy and the story with Desmond was stupid.
Yeah, well, they did fix the glitches in 3, but
yeah,
it doesn't come away from the fact that he's... Connor's really serious.
Yeah. That's why I like Haytham better than Connor.
Yeah.
Anyway, we'll talk more Assassin's Creed on the next episode. See you guys next time.